Hi Lalas, welcome back! If you're new, welcome to my channel. I'm Gaia and I'm a language lover. And you? When I started studying English at school, my teacher used to say, English is an easy language to learn, but sometimes the mistake is hidden in the sunlight, because some words are very similar in Italian and in English and they come natural to you. Others instead just seems very similar in Italian and in English and they come natural to you too. But then you may be embarrassed. I'm talking about the so-called false friends. I don't know if you have them in your language too, but Italian and English false friends are more than you thought and probably more than you hoped for. But don't worry, some words are so common you probably already learned, and others are not so used and you don't need to remember the false friends. As usual, let's see together the most common false friends and at the end a more complete list. And now, let's get started. The first false friend I personally ever met is factory. That seems fattoria, but factory means fabbrica. Fattoria instead is farm. My second one was pavement. The Italian translation is marciapiede and not pavimento. Another very common is library. In Italian, biblioteca, and not libreria. Parents are important, but also parenti are important. But don't confuse them, because parents is genitori. Parenti instead is relatives. Okay, next one is actually, in realtà, and not attualmente. In realtà, remember this. Another common word is definitely. The Italian false friend is definitivamente, but the real translation is certamente. A good one is eventually. Not eventualmente, but alla fine. It is a very common one, actually. Actually. And let's continue with rumors. That's pettegolezzi and not rumore. Actually, I don't like rumors, neither rumore. If you're a photographer, you use a camera. But in Italian, you use macchinetta fotografica. Because camera is the room. An addiction is a very bad thing. But in Italian, it's bad just in case if you're first day of elementary school and you hate math. Just kidding. Addiction is dipendenza. Talking about a house, you may have an attic. But if you have un attico, you're very lucky. Quite the same for canteen, mensa. Ma cantina è meglio. A very similar meaning for petrol, benzina, and not petrolio. But petrol is made from petrolio, so not be mistake. We can eat ostriche during a special dinner. An ostrich, struzzo, is more difficult to find on your dinner table. Sometimes you pretend to be someone else, but in Italian is fingere, not pretendere. Never ask if a certain food has preservativi. At least you may ask for conservanti. Education and educazione are both important, so put yourself into them. An advice, consiglio, is not always accepted, but pay attention if you see an avviso. If you're sensible, sensato, it doesn't mean you're also sensibile. If you want to read something, a novel, romanzo, may be perfect. But if you prefer something shorter, una novella is the thing for you. Same thing for a romance, una storia d'amore. A vacancy could be an opportunity for you. Una vacanza could be an opportunity too, or just a week to rest. To annoy means infastidire and not annoiare. And now, at the end of this video, I hope you're more confident with your Italian skills, but hope you have also un confidente, because it's nice to have someone to talk with. We are almost done, don't worry. Okay, that's it for today. I hope you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe and follow me on my Instagram. Thanks a lot for watching and see you in the next video. Ciao!